Welcome to my photography class. In this video, you will learn what shutter speed is and how it affects your exposure. So first, what is shutter speed? To understand shutter speed, first we should know what shutter is. When light travels through your camera lens and the aperture, it goes through your shutter. This shutter is a curtain that blocks light to reach your camera sensor. In a DSLR, when you press your camera shutter release button, that big button to take your photo, the mirror flips up and lets light pass into the camera instead of the viewfinder. After this, a small curtain moves from top to bottom to expose the sensor. Beneath after that, another curtain falls down to cover up the entire sensor. After the second curtain closes, the mirror falls back to its position and curtains go up to their original position. The time between this opening and closing of the curtains, or the exact time of exposure, how long the image sensor exposed to light, is called shutter speed. It is also a way you can creatively blur or freeze motion in your composition. Your camera only needs a fraction of a second to capture the image, and that is how shutter speed is represented as a fraction, like 1/25th of a second, 1/50th of a second, 1/80th of a second, up to 1/4000th of a second and beyond. Now, how do you adjust the shutter speed of your camera? Similar to the aperture, depending on your camera model, there will be a dial to adjust the shutter speed. Does shutter speed affect your exposure? Let's check it out. As you can see here, our shutter speed is set to 1/80th of a second and our subject is properly exposed. Now, if we go down to this and take a shot, you can see here that you are getting an overexposed image. Now let's go up to faster shutter speed and again take a shot. Here you can see that we get an underexposed image. So the result is that a faster shutter speed lets in less light and a slower shutter speed lets in more light. Therefore, if you are in a situation that is too dark, you can slow down your shutter speed to expose properly. There is also one other important thing about shutter speed. If you are photographing a subject that is in motion, you will get different effect at different shutter speed. Faster shutter speed will freeze your motion, while if your shutter speed is slow, moving subject in your photo will appear blurred along the direction of motion. This can be because of two things: camera movement, means the camera shake, and from the object movement. Camera shake is one of the most common issue for new photographers, typically for beginners. I recommend shooting with a shutter speed faster than 1/80th or even 1/100th of a second to prevent the camera shake. Using a tripod is an alternative way to prevent camera shake while shooting with longer shutter speed. So now you know what shutter speed is and how it affects exposure. Just go out and play around with your shutter speed settings in different situations, in different locations. Good day.